professional handle checking your AC for those homes that have ACs, or are these checks something that a homeowner could do themselves?
Well, I would probably recommend a professional inspect your AC unit once a year. That's pretty well standard in the industry. However, if you're the type that wants to do it yourself, well, these are the following steps that I would probably do. The very first thing that you should do with your air conditioning unit when you want to get it up and running in the spring is take the cover off. If you operate your air conditioner compressor with a cover on it, you will ruin it right away. So make sure you remove the cover. The next thing I would do is remove any of the debris. And again, just like your furnace intake, you get that same kind of poplar fluff stuck on all the fins of the compressor unit on the outside. You can take a vacuum. Some people will actually take the lid off of the air conditioner with a hose, blow out from the inside all the way out and try to remove that from the exterior. But anyways, get it clean. Make sure it's level. Air conditioners will work much better and last much longer if the compressor unit is level. So that's another thing to do. The other thing is that your refrigerant lines, one of your refrigerant line will have an insulation on it. And you've got to make sure that that's in good condition, because I've seen those deteriorate really badly, and that will affect the performance of the unit. So make sure that that's done on the outside. The next thing that you should do is maybe go down into the furnace, and there is a condensate tray in the furnace underneath the A coil, which is the unit that basically brings in the cooling, and make sure that the drain pipes are all clean. Make sure that the pipe that drains that condensate into your floor drain is in good condition and draining properly. The next thing I would do then is turn on the main breaker and let the unit heat up. You must let the unit heat up for 24 hours before you operate the air conditioner. Oh. So by turning on that main breaker, there is a heater heating the oil in the compressor unit, and they want 24 hours for that oil to get thin enough to flow, and so you don't do any damage to the unit. So those are certainly the things that I would do. Oh, the other thing that I would recommend is go into the basement. If you have only one air conditioner in your home, you should close all the heat registers in the basement. That's generally the rule of thumb with an air conditioner. The idea of doing that is it tends to move all the cold air to the second floor, and that way you'll have good cooling for the bedroom areas where you want it, but also that cold air is more dense and it will find its way down into the basement. If you don't close the ones in the basement, you're gonna freeze downstairs and you're not gonna have the cooling up into the bedroom areas. The other thing that's very important with an air conditioner is that if you have a humidifier, and most homes do, there's a damper on that humidifier that must be turned into the closed position for the summertime. If you do not close that damper on the humidifier, your cold air is just going to circulate around the furnace all summer long, and you're not going to get that cold air to the second floor, so make sure you close that damper. And the damper will often say open or close, or it'll say summer and winter. So if it says summer, put it to summer. If it says open and close, you want it into the closed position.
The closed position. That's awesome. That's
very important.
Awesome. That's some awesome.